Executing system commands on the programming language level sounds like asking for trouble. But how to do it right and safe? This in today's From Zero to Pentesting Hero. In PHP, if you want to use the system command that allows you to execute any program from the operating system, we should use one of the two commands, escapeshell command or escapeshell argument. But how do these two functions differ from each other? And what is the difference in their usage? Can you use them interchangeably? Let's start with the first function, escapeshell argument. Its use assures that the user has given exactly one parameter to the command chosen by us. User cannot provide more parameters or execute another command. The standard usage looks like this. The programmer selects the command which execution wants to allow, for example, dir, so that the user can list any directory. The parameter provided by the user is passed to the escapeshell argument function. The second function, escapeshell command, ensure that only one command will be executed. It's not possible to inject additional commands using a trick with a semicolon or pipe. But this command can contain an infinite number of parameters. So if we decide to use it, we must make sure that any parameter cannot be used incorrectly. The most common mistake is to use the escapeshell command function instead of escapeshell argument. Let's see the code of today's example application. The user can download any website using wget. This page will be saved to the temp directory, which is located outside of the web server. The point is that the downloaded script should not be interpreted by PHP. We achieved this thanks to the directory prefix parameter, which allows you to specify the directory to which the downloaded file will be saved. Let's check how this example of application works. We are downloading the Google's website. Indeed, the file index.html appeared in the temp directory. The programmer used the escapeshell command function in this code, so it is possible to specify an additional parameter to wget. We can then pass the second parameter, directory prefix, which this time points to the current directory. Wget allows you to specify multiple directory parameters, but only the last one is used. So we can download any file with the PHP extension, and it will be saved to the current directory. Because the current directory allows you to execute PHP files, we have just gained the ability to execute code remotely on this server. For example, I am downloading the exploit.php file that has the function phpinfo, which gives basic information about a given installation. Because the file was downloaded to the current directory, I can now run it without any problem. So how do you protect yourself against this attack? Use the escapeshell argument functions. If you are interested in this topic, I invite you to visit my website where I describe this problem in more details. And that's all in today's episode. If you like it, leave a thumb up and subscribe to this channel. See you next time. Bye!